पर घट तक है तेरी कहानी पग पग प्यारे दंगल 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 सूरज तेरा चढ़ता ढलता गर्दिश में करते हैं तारे दंगल 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 दंगल
great morning my dear friends Bhupesh Anand this side so today we will be doing something about you know diminishing marginal returns or the diminishing marginal productivity so these are the flow charts which we will be doing with so today will be the today is the last third lecture number 3 we are on prerequisite for CFA level 1 examination demand and supply analysis the firm structure we are doing the basic part in the firm structure and today I will be just dealing with two small aspects that what are the different factors of production that is learning outcome number the learning outcome number C we are doing learning outcome C that what are the different types of factors of production and what is the meaning of marginal diminishing productivity if we increase the labor and if we increase the capital then something will be there that I will be telling you so please take out your registers only very small lecture today I'll be dealing with two concepts one is what are the different inputs what are the resources what are the factors of production which are required by the producers you know we have discussed in the lecture number 1 in reading in demand and supply analysis in production that there are three types of market one is factor market second is product market third is capital market now I am talking of factor market that in that factor market different factors are available and this producer Apollo tires Infosys pharmaceutical Fevicol Patanjali they require some factors of production you know and that can be land that can be you know labor that can be capital employed that can be the buildings and all those factors of production are required then only they can produce a finished product so today I will be focusing on those factors of production and along with that I will be focusing that when we increase you know when we increase the factors of production to extent then the actual marginal productivity the marginal productivity will decline the marginal productivity will decline so these are the two basic points which I want to discuss with to discuss the firm's factors of production believe in yourself the first point which I want to throw on you that is factors of production are the resources factors of production are the resources they are the input they are the factors of production they are the input a firm uses to produce these are the resources a firm uses to produce its output now they can be land labor material capital now out of that these four factors of production you know land is limited labor is unlimited but it depends whether we require skilled labor unskilled labor or semi skilled labor but these are the four factors of production but the point is which I want to tell you that if I increase more labor or if I increase more capital actually they have the tendency of diminishing marginal productivity it means if a group of laborers are doing a work and they are producing this much number of units and if I add a new labor a new worker then the total number of units which are being produced will be less because that is aimed as diminishing return diminishing marginal productivity so just whether you have written first point please write down first point factors of production are the resources input a firm uses to produce its output factors of production are the resources or are the input which the firm uses to produce its output okay so these are the factors of production now they all these out of these four two factors of production they have diminishing marginal productivity they have diminishing marginal productivity diminishing marginal productivity as the name indicates if we increase you know the workers or the capital every new dollar introduced as a capital it will decline my ROI return on investment and similarly if I introduce a new worker it will reduce you know the productivity of all the workers that is named as marginal decline in the productivity so marginal diminishing productivity is I think that's the second point it may be noted that marginal productivity is applicable to only to labor and to capital. Now, when I say labor, I have given examples that how it is applicable to a labor. Suppose there are 10 workers and they are producing 100 units. Now, if I introduce an 11th worker, then the total output will be 107 units. It means the additional worker has only produced 7 units. It means earlier that the workers were producing, one worker is producing 10 units. So it means there is a downfall, there is a decline in the productivity. That is named as marginal diminishing productivity. So please write an example number 1. Suppose at T0, existing scenario, 10 employees are working to produce, are able to produce 100 units at T0, and I have introduced a new worker, and that new worker, after that new worker, if I see the production at T1, the total they have produces 107 units. It implies, supposedly, at now at this, they are able to produce only 107 units. It means one additional worker is only contributing 7. It is named as diminishing marginal productivity. Similarly, on capital also, when we introduce excess capital, then that has a tendency of declining my ROI, return on investment. Supposedly, in case of a companies, service industries where there is no capital requirement is there. For example, in case of IT companies, Infosys, Wipro, TCS, there is no requirement of capital. But if I introduce a huge capital, then my ROI will decline. So labor and capital, they have the propensity, a diminishing marginal propensity. So just see from Google Baba that what Google Baba is showing us, these are the marginal decrease in the law of diminishing marginal productivity. Number of workers, total output, marginal product, and it will decrease. Just see labor and capital, there is a decline fall in the new production. So that is named as marginal decline or marginal diminishing productivity. So for today, this is only the learning outcome which we are covering. No doubt in next lecture, I will be discussing the most important concept, that what is the meaning of a cost? What is variable cost? What is fixed cost? How many types of cost are there? What is the nature of that? How? What is total cost? So please be there in the next lecture number 4. Be happy, be jolly, be cheerful.